Put it over your neck. Got it. That's the movies, right?
I don't like competing with the cars, though. Welcome to the home of Assassin's Creed, Wild State Park. My name is Ken, I'm one of the park rangers. I'm going to be talking about Manatees, but first I have to tell you a couple things. If you got a cell phone, please lower it down so you can interrupt the program. You can hear the cars from the road already, so I had to compete with those. Sunday's the Harley Davidson going by. And then if you're a smoker, the park is a non-smoking park. Please do not smoke in the park. We have a smoking lounge out of the exit. If you go at the entrance to the ride, they got a smoking lounge out there. Well, we don't let people smoke in the park because everybody can flip in their cigarette butts in the animals exhibits. Okay? So not cool. So you get with that, solutions like cabbage, iceberg, Napa, you name it, kale, anything that Sleepy Green disguise will eat. They love sweets. Figure that out. Carrots, apples, pears, bananas, they'll eat anything we can eat. But we don't feel all stuff because imagine you're sitting in a chair eating cookies and chips and soda all day long. What's going to happen? It ain't going to happen with them. So, we try to keep them on the lean diet. What are they going to eat in the wild? Any vegetation that grows in the water? Literally anything? Any trees that falls out of, any leaves that fall out of the trees, they'll eat that. Usually in the park, with the winds and the rain, the tree will fall in the water or a branch. You gonna get it out? Tomorrow. Why? By the time I come back tomorrow, it's clean. Oh, I gotta pull a bill and stick out on the water. Okay? So they'll eat any kind of vegetation out there in the water. Now, that's kind of the cool thing about manatees. We're gonna talk about why we're herding manatee. Last winter, 2009-2010. And you read the numbers about manatees being killed with the full weather and record numbers? Manatees, being warm-blooded, they need warm water to survive. We're warm-blooded. What happens if we don't consistently drink water with any kind of dry to the west so that we stay for a long period of time? What's going to happen?
He's bigger than you.
Yeah, he's bigger than you.
Yeah. Even if you sell for a short period of time, what's going to happen with you?
He's fat.
Look,
he's going under the boat.
So imagine this manatee's being breathing on that wall, that cold air too, it doesn't make any good. So a manatee's in cold weather will be a big factor. That's why they come up to this real runs where the water's paying about 74 degrees and they can get the warm water that way. Or you see them in the power plant, you see the picture of the power plant, and you see little manatees around the warm water, and the water coming out of the turbines, all that water coming out of the power plant is probably 100 degrees or more. So if you got 60 degree water and you find some 90-degree water, what you gonna do? I'm gonna 90 degree water and survive. Okay, and that's what they do. So the weather, big factor. Now what else can hurt a manatee? Boats. What else? Fishing line. What else?
Man.
What?
Man.
Humans. Okay? Every time I ask the question, boats come in line, propellers come in line, fishing line. What about cigarette butts, plastic bags, coke cans, you name it. All that belongs to? Humans.
Man.
Our garbage hurt manatees. Manatees are very curious animals. Spray. See how clean it is? Do we have such a thing as an underwater lawnmower? No and yes. No mechanical, but yes natural. They're the lawnmower. They come up the river and they eat all the natural debris in the bottom. When they move those plastic panels, you never seen a manatee moving in a hurry? You gotta see one. You get out of the way. When they move that tail, the sediment will move out. But when they come up the river, imagine 80 manatees coming the winter up the river, chewing all in their path, moving all that sediment so we can use our boats up and down the river. When I have manatees come up the river, guess what? You're gonna need a couple of propellers in the back of your boat. You're gonna be doing them behind. If you never be stranded in the boat because you hit a sand bar or an oyster bar, the best way I can put it, you're in the turnpike, floating this turnpike, you're on any main highway, at 2 o'clock in the morning, your tire went out, your spare is flat, what do you do? And you have those zones that you go with no cell phone?
Okay.
That's what's going to happen out there. The more you're in the water, you're going to know where you're going to end. At least on land, you're steady.